This is the Insta360 ONE X. Here I have the GoPro Hero 8 Black, brand new for this year. I've been a GoPro user for about 5 years. I've loved GoPros. There's been a lot of awesome things for me personally and to help me grow this channel and things that I produce every day. But Insta360's been making a lot of waves in the action sport community, and they reached out to me. They wanted to send me a camera to test it out to see if it could dethrone the GoPro as something that I'd want to use every day. This thing is awesome. There's a lot of really great things about it. I want to share that with you today in today's video review. Without further ado, let's get into it.
I don't get to score very often, buddy. You better get that one up on the YouTube channel. Trav for Oilers, right here.
Hey, thanks for the Shinedown tickets too, by the way.
Oh, absolutely, man.
To stabilize it, try to get close to the net if you can.
Okay. I hope I got that. I hope I might have had the roof, but I don't know, we'll see.
95-35.
Smile.
When it goes to produce the actual 360 video, it edits this whole entire pullout. Now, it won't edit this out, but you can put it on and this will not be in the video. I'll show you some clips here. You wouldn't even know that I have it mounted anywhere. Actually, the clip I'm gonna show you here is mounted on the net. Looks like it's just a floating camera. It looks really, really cool. This is what the full thing looks like. You can actually set it up as a tripod too, which is really nice. But the only downside is that if you're holding it, you'll have this invisible floating hand that looks like this and kind of is a dead giveaway that you're holding the camera. You can find a way to mount it, I think, without having your hand around it and have it stationary. Also, don't use this piece. Looks like a floating camera. You get some seriously, seriously out of this world cool shots. First thing I really love about this camera. Now, this thing shoots in 5K, 4K, and 3K. There's 5K at 30 frames a second, 4K at 50 frames per second, and 3K at 100 frames per second. Now, that may seem like a lot. 5K, 4K, even 3K seems like a great resolution, but we're talking about a picture size, well, a video picture image that is 5K for capturing everything. So by the time you take that video file and you shrink it down into an actual video image, we're talking about a very low resolution video, especially when the 3K at 100 frames per second is already kind of fishy as is. And what I mean by that is that it's kind of blurry. It's kind of, well, I'll show you right here. That's at 100 frames per second, and it doesn't look great. With action sports, you need to have everything filmed at 60 frames per second. Reason being is that more frames captures the details. There's a lot of action going on. There's a lot of information that the camera needs to capture, from puck movement, skaters moving, all that kind of stuff. Doesn't matter what sport you're playing. 30 frames per second doesn't cut it because it doesn't capture the action fast enough. 50, I guess, could pass because it's basically 60 frames per second. But the 100 should be 120 so that I can divvy things up my timeline better when I'm actually creating the videos, because 120, 60, 30, everything makes sense there, as opposed to 30, 50, 100. So there are some things that Insta360 does need to fix about this camera. Now, price point, I think, is the big winner here, because at $400, you're getting a 360 camera that also doubles as an action camera, and you can also take some pictures with it. Pictures aren't great, but you can take pictures with it, and the audio is actually pretty decent. And you can already judge for yourself from the audio files that I've shown so far. But for $400, you can get the Insta360 ONE X. For $500, you can get the GoPro Hero 8 Black. Or for $800, you can get the GoPro Hero Max, which is basically the Hero 8 plus the 360 camera at the same time. I'd never spend $800 on a camera like that, but I think if you're tight on cash, this might be the way to go. Worst things about it is the pain in the ass that it is to actually take all the footage you get. You have this raw file with full 360 degree footage, and then at that point in time, you have to go into the editor and choose frame by frame what you want. So you're actually moving the camera yourself. Now, I will say this, the results that you can get with this camera from the 360 ability, especially with the net cam that I've already showed you a couple times, is absolutely incredible. Like, there is nothing that compares to this, and it looks like somebody's actually operating an NHL style net cam. I'll show you a comparison right here. I value my time. I value my time a lot, actually. And when I can just set up a GoPro and it captures what I want, it gets everything that I need. Sometimes the shot's a little bit out of focus or a little bit out of frame, but I can actually adjust it after
It's great. Now with the 360 camera, it captures everything, so I don't have to worry about that anymore, and I save a little bit of time, but now I have to spend almost quadruple the amount of time to go on after into the video editor, into the Insta360 ONE X program, and choose frame by frame what I wanted to focus on, how much I wanted to zoom in, what I wanted to look at. If I have an hour ice time, I have to look over an hour of footage. That's the one big drawback, and I want to explain the editor and that system itself right now.
The hardest thing is taking the footage from here, the 360 video on the Insta360 ONE X, and converting it over to here, picking your frames, and actually having some usable footage. It takes a lot of time, and I want to show you that right now, that process.
Okay, so with this clip, I am choosing the angle that the camera represents. So that movement, that's me in post-secondary, choosing what it looks at and what it sees. When I'm in the editor, this lock direction button basically picks the frame for you. And in that moment, you have to change, am I going left, am I going right? And you have to hold that frame and go back and forth. I don't have any fresh files on hand, but this is a pain in the ass, and I don't like this.
To conclude, would I recommend Insta360 ONE X? Absolutely. When you're paying $400 for the 360 ONE X, you can pay $530 for the Hero 8 Black, I think almost $600, or you can pay like $800 for the Hero Max, which is also a 360 camera. It's a no-brainer here that financially the Insta360 ONE X makes sense. For me, I value my time, so I will use the Insta360 ONE X when I have the time and I have the ability to take the time to pick out all my frames and all that kind of stuff. But if I am a little tight for time and I need to just get the shot, which is what I've learned in the last year and a half, is my priority. Get the shot, focus on getting that shot, because if you don't have it, it doesn't matter. That is why I'm gonna be using the GoPro Hero 8 Black for a lot of my other shots. I do endorse the 360 ONE X, I think it's a great camera, but there's some things that need to be fixed. There's a way to maybe, you can focus on the puck, or you can focus on a certain player, you can focus on certain objects and have it just follow that around in the editor, save you so much time, but that's not a possibility right now. So 360 ONE X, awesome camera, highly recommend it. Also, quick announcement, gonna be giving away an Insta360 ONE X camera. Now, I'm just announcing the giveaway here. We're gonna do another announcement telling you all the details of the giveaway on December 16th on that video, and then on the 23rd, I think the 23rd, I could be wrong, I'll put it on the screen, we're gonna pick the winner. So if you want to win an Insta360 ONE X, it's worth, well, $400 plus. So if you want to win an Insta360 ONE X, December 16th, that video, so a week from today, we'll give you all the details. Good luck to everybody who enters, and I cannot wait to share that with you, because it's an awesome camera, and I think that someone's gonna have an awesome Christmas when they win this camera. Best luck to everybody, and see you in the next video.
Now, I was instructed by Insta360 to announce we're gonna give away one of these bad boys. So again, this will conclude the video. Thanks for watching, and we're gonna call it a video.
As always, this video is brought to you in part by SidelineSwap.com. Sideline Swap will not break your heart. They will never do anything to really hurt you. They'll just give you good deals in sporting equipment, whether it be pro return, new or used. We're also doing a gift card giveaway right away, so stay tuned for that.